Hey guys, this is Anthony Morganti. I am MrPhotographer.com. Well, just the other day, On1 Software released the latest version of On1 Photo Raw. It's now On1 Photo Raw 2021. This new edition of the software has a lot of new features. In this video, I'm going to cover two of the more significant new features of the software. After I do that, I'm going to read off all the new features that are in this software. And if in future videos you want me to cover anything specific, let me know in the comments below. Also, in the description below the video, I'll have a list of all the new features. I'll also have links to the software. They have a 14-day free trial, and I'll have my discount code so when you purchase it, you could save some money, and all that good stuff will all be listed in the description below. Now, a couple of new features they have that I'm going to be covering in this video is the new Portrait AI. Now, I did do a video on the standalone version of Portrait AI about a month ago. The Portrait AI that is integrated in On1 Photo Raw 2021 is the same exact thing, but I want to cover it again just in case people didn't see that video. And also another new feature is the new spot healing brush that is non-destructive, and I'm going to cover that as well. Now, when you have a portrait and you load it into On1 Photo Raw 2021, you could come in first and do like some tone and color adjustments, sharpening with details and lens corrections, of course. Then when you're ready to do the portrait part of the image, that means, you know, the skin, the eyes, the lips and stuff, you would jump and just click on Portrait AI. And when you do that, On1 will examine the image and find the face or faces that are in the image and automatically mask those. Now you could see right at the top, if I click on it, it found the face of this person. You could see it has a mask, and you could see it's how it's in the exact shape of their face, and you'll be defaulted. You'll get a brush there so you could add to the mask or remove from the mask. Now I'm just going to close that mask part down for now, and I'm going to go back to the view tool. But when I opened up the image in Portrait AI, it automatically did some adjustments to the face. Watch, I'm going to turn this off. What? Look at her face. There's before and there's after. Now you could see it softened her skin slightly, and it did enhance her eyes actually quite a bit. There's before and there's after. So be aware of that. As soon as you open a portrait in Portrait AI, it will do some adjusting already. Now we'll go through real quick. You have different styles, you know, where you could just kind of like their presets for Portrait AI. Like you could do skin and eyes strong or skin and eyes subtle, skin only strong, and so on. And as you could see, as I hover over these different styles, you'll get a preview of that style on the image itself. I'll just stay with the default style for now. Now, when you go to the skin retouching section of Portrait AI, you'll be presented with a single slider, and you can move it to the right, of course, to soften the skin further. And you can see how it's doing advanced softening. It's actually not blurring out the skin. It's actually doing like a frequency separation. And to prove that, if you go right here to this where it says details, you see that little kind of arrow? That's an expose triangle. And if you click on it, you roll it open, you'll see that we're doing frequency separation. And you could instead do surface blur. For some portraits, surface blur may work better than frequency separation, or maybe you just prefer surface blur. If that's the case, you could do that. When you do that, you could see the sliders below will change, but we'll stay with frequency separation. And you have individual sliders now for different things. Blemish removal, you can move that to the right to do a more heavier blemish removal process. Detail, you could add detail back into the pores. You can see how as I move it to the right, as I move it to the left, you can see it looks a little more blurred. And as I move it to the right, we're bringing that detail back. Smoothing, just especially like if you, in this case, you could see that there's some bags under her eyes, and if I move it to the right, it kind of smooths it all out a little bit. Texture just adds a little texture to the skin. And shine, if there was shine, you could remove it with that slider as well. So you have the individual sliders. Most often, maybe you would be fine just using the single retouching slider. That's kind of like a master volume control for everything. If it's fine, fine. Then you could, you know, speed up your workflow by just moving that one slider. Now, for the face, we do have some specific adjustments. First of all, brightness. You could just brighten up her face. I like to do that on my portraits. I like to make them a little brighter. If you need, you could slim her face. In this case here, I don't need to. Most often, I would do this if I'm shooting with a wide-angle lens and I have the subject rather close to my camera, because then with the wide-angle lens, it tends to distort the face and make it look a little wider than it actually is. In those cases, I want to correct for that distortion by slimming the face with that. Now, it has eye size for left and right eye. A lot of glamour portrait photographers like to increase the size of their model's eyes, like just a little bit. Typically, we used to do this in Photoshop, and you would use a specific type of enlarge tool in Photoshop, and you would just do it 10%. That was kind of like the rule. You didn't want to go above 10%. Just make the eye slightly larger. It just makes the portrait usually look a little bit more interesting. What I like to do it for, and I appreciate the fact that On1 has individual sliders for both eyes, meaning left eye and right eye, because quite often, especially if you're using, again, a wider angle lens for a portrait, which, you know, most often people don't, though that's why they have a 85 millimeter and 105 millimeter lens that are specific portrait lenses, because those lenses in that focal length range tend not to distort the face. But there are times maybe when you're doing maybe full body shots with a 35 millimeter lens or a 23 millimeter lens, and then you want to get in closer and get a headshot or head and shoulder shot. And when you do that, it'll distort the face, tend to make the face a little wider, and you could slim it with that slider. Or if they have one eye that's a little closer to the camera and the other eye a little further away, it's going to make the eyes look different. One eye will be larger than the other. And pretty much if you really look at people's faces in general, most of us don't have eyes that the exact same size. A lot of people don't realize that. But most of us will have one eye slightly smaller than the other eye. Now, in this case, you could see her right eye is a little bit smaller than her left eye. Her left eye is just a tiny bit closer to the camera. Now, to me, it looks okay as is. But if you wanted to equalize it, you could go to this right eye slider, and you could see how you could move it to the right and just make them a little more equal if you want to do that. Now, as far as the eyes themselves, you could whiten the whites of the eyes, move that to the right. You could add more detail into her iris. You could see you can make it look like marbles if you wanted to, very kind of fake looking. Or you could just bring out some detail if you'd like. You could help remove those dark circles under her eyes, move that to the right. You could see how it reduces that. I'll move that a relative significant amount. You could enhance her eyebrows. It just makes them a little darker. So you could see how it automatically does that. Now, one thing I just want to point out again is I didn't do anything here. I just opened the portrait into Portrait AI. It automatically knew where her eyes were, her eyebrows were, her lips, everything. I didn't have to add any type of guide or masking over her eyes, over her lips to tell it where those specific things were on her face. It automatically found those. Auto red eye removal if you used a flash and you have red eye. She's not showing your teeth, so teeth whitening isn't applicable. We could add some vibrance to her lips, and we could add some lip brightness, lip hue, so you could change the color, like she's wearing a specific color lipstick if you wanted to. You could do that as well. So you could see that this is very powerful, powerful tool, and it will really help you do a portrait in just a fraction of the time. Now, I'll give you a before after, because as we're adjusting things, it tends to look the same when it isn't. There's before, and there's after. So you could see that it did a significant amount of processing to her face. Now, the second new thing that is in On1 Photo Raw 2021 I want to talk about is the new spot healing brush. Now, she has a blemish right here that the Portrait AI 2 did not take care of. So if I go over to retouch right here and I click on that, you can see that's the healing brush. The keyboard shortcut is Q. So we'll click on that. And this is a new technology that's in this version of On1 Photo Raw. It's non-destructive. And those of you that use Lightroom or something like that, it's similar to that. Now, if we go at the top, you can see that there's the healing brush there. We also have the perfect eraser. We have the retouch brush, and we have the clone stamp tool. So just remember that this one retouch section contains four different tools. But we're going to talk about that healing brush. So I'll leave the size at 40, feathers at 25. That's the default, I believe. We'll leave it there. And what you would do is this little blemish right here, if I just paint over that area like this and then let go, what it will do is it will look for part of on her face that is similar in tone and texture and color, and it will just match it up. And you could see that it took care of it. Now, if you don't like what it did, you could move this around, just click on it and drag it to a different spot. And you could see it kind of what it's doing on her face. So you could move it to a different area. And then when you're done, you just go up here and click done. And just like that, we got rid of that blemish. And as I mentioned, that's non-destructive. So you could totally undo that. You don't have to worry about it messing with the pixels on your image. So those are probably two significant new features of On1 Photo Raw 2021. Now, I mentioned I'm going to read off all the new features. If you don't want to listen to me read all this stuff, in the description below this video, I'll have a list of all this stuff that I'm talking about. And if there's anything specific you want me to do a video on in the future, let me know in the comments section. Also, in the description below the video, I'll have links so you could try out the software or buy it. I also have a discount code, and you could check that all out in the description below the video. All right, we talked about On1 Portrait AI in the Spot Healing Brush. Another new feature they have is the Replace Color Filter. Easily change the color of an object to any new color. It's perfect for tweaking or changing the color of an object, of objects like eyes, flowers, buildings, and apparel. Next new feature, Custom Brush Shapes. Brushing has taken a quantum leap in control and creativity. Choose from a variety of custom brush shapes or even import brush collections. The new flow control in brushing makes building up a mask more natural too. Smart Organize Mode. Take control over cluttered photo archives. Quickly find duplicates or find and group photos that have similar appearance, location, or time. Smart Organize Mode can help cull photo libraries to find the best photo in a series. Color-sensitive gradient masks. Combine the new color-sensitive technology with gradient masks. When enabled, it detects the color under the gradient and applies the mask to only that adjustable color range. It makes it a breeze to mask areas like skies while maintaining things like buildings or trees that go into the sky. New plugin support. In addition to working as plugins for Adobe Lightroom, Photoshop, and Apple Photos, On1 now extends into those using workflows in Affinity Photo, Corel, PaintShop Pro, and Capture One. It says coming soon for Capture One. Easy access to On1 Develop, Effects, and Portrait AI are available right inside these apps as plugins. Quick Slideshow and Full Screen Preview. In only one click, launch a full screen slideshow complete with user-friendly delay and elegant dissolve transition. Or use the new full screen preview mode to maximize your work area on a small screen. Batch HDR and panorama. Save time by batch processing HDO brackets and panoramas. Organize brackets into subfolders, then let On1 browse, build new HDR and panos automatically. A lifesaver for real estate photographers. Color fill layers. In On1 layers, quickly set a background color for a composite layout. They are also handy when used with the new custom brush shapes for painting in objects like grass, trees, and clouds. It also has a list of new cameras and new lens profiles. I'll have that listed below, and it just says that it did some bug fixes bugs that were in On1 Photo Raw 2020 have been fixed for On1 Photo Raw 2021. Again, I'll have all that listed in the description below the video. That's it for this video. I'd like to thank everyone who watches my videos. I really do appreciate it. I'll talk to you guys soon.